Grammar, 문법. Today we'll study some accusative cases of Korean language. 에게 and 한테. For example, let's read these sentences. 동생에게 책을 줘요. 동생한테 책을 줘요. This means I give a book younger brother to younger brother. In this case, 동생에게 or 동생한테 means to younger brother. 에게 and 한테 mean to. The English preposition to is accusative case. You can read the meaning in English. 오케이, then watch this table. Always known plus 에게 or 한테 when there is 받침 or not. For example, 동생, 동생에게, 누나, 누나에게. Okay? Okay, then let's practice together. Here is exercise. 연습 1. 알맞은 말을 쓰세요. Okay, then question number 1. You can read these sentences and answer, and then translate this in English. Okay, then number 1. 가영 씨가 리사 씨. Answer, please. Okay, 에게 전화를 해요. And the next one. 가영 씨가 리사 씨 오케이 한테 전화를 해요. And please practice translate into Korean. And number 2. 나타샤 씨는 친구 오케이 에게 편지를 써요. 나타샤 씨는 친구 오케이 한테 편지를 써요. And the last one. 쯔옹 씨가 저에게 선물을 줬어요. 쯔옹 씨가 저한테 선물을 줬어요. Okay. And the next page. We will study this suffix 만. Known plus 만 means only known or just known. For example, let's read these sentences together. 저와 언니는 회사원이에요. 동생만 학생이에요. 동생만 means only younger brother or younger sister. Understood? Okay. Then you can try to read the meaning in English. And watch this table. This is also known plus 만 means only known when there is 받침 or not. It is always known plus 만. Watch this exception. 이 or 가 을 or를 자리에 모두 쓸 수 있다. In other words, known plus 이 가 means subject in the sentence. Known plus 을을 this means object in a sentence. and you can try, you can use this suffix man also at the place of 이가 or 을을. For example, 리사 씨는 노래를 좋아해요. This is 리사 씨는 노래만 좋아해요. This is possible too. Okay? But meaning is different. 노래를 means just a sing. Just a song, just a song. But 노래만 means only song. The meanings are different. Be careful with this. Okay, then let's try to decide, solve this exercise. 연습 2. 알맞은 말을 쓰세요. Question number 1. You can try to read this sentence in Korean and then translate this into English, okay? Okay. 쯔엉 씨는 누나가 있어요. 쯔엉 씨는 동생이 없어요. Then answer. 쯔엉 씨는 누나만 있어요. Only elder sister. Okay? Mm-hmm. 누나만. Question number 2. 나타샤 씨는 친구에게 편지를 보내요. 선물은 없어요. 나타샤 씨는 친구에게 편지만 보내요. 편지만 means only letter. Okay? Okay, then next page. Here is some more exercises. You can try to solve this by yourselves. And here, there are more exercises. Here, two. And at the next page, listen and speaking. 듣고 말하기. 여러분은 친구에게 어떻게 인사합니까? 여러분은 친구 생일에 무엇을 줍니까? You can try to read this dialogue with this QR code. And then, please answer the questions at the next page.